Hello, yes. This is RetroTK2, and welcome to this C# tutorial. Today we're customizing our code color, yes. We'll take a look at a variety of ways to do this, both with the standard color and resharpers. A fair knowledge of C# is probably needed here, yes, to distinguish between the identifiers, but having colorful code makes it easier to learn, in my opinion. So let's get started. Download the channel files, yes. You can use the link in this video's description or the one on my channel art. Extract the files and open the folder. Click Video Files, Series 1, C# Code Color, Code Color, and click on the .sln file. This will open up Visual Studio Ace. Click on the Example Standard Code Color file. This file has usages of the common C# elements. You'll need to turn off Resharper's color identifiers, Ace, as they may hide the standard ones. Go to Google, search Studio Styles, and click the first link. From here you can download a ready-made theme or create your own. The interface for creating your own theme is pretty cool, Ace. If you hover over a specific piece of code, you get the name of the element it corresponds to. Clicking on the element brings up a dialog box and you can change the foreground and background color. You can also change the text to bold. Once you're finished, click the download.vs settings to download your created theme. I'm not going to do that, Ace. Instead, I'm going to download a ready-made theme. If I click on the Sons of Obsidian theme, I get the option to download the scheme. Once it's downloaded, jump back into Visual Studio and open the Color Theme tab. Create a copy of the theme and select it. Click Tools, then Import and Export Settings. Select Import Selected Environment Settings and click Next. I usually save my current settings just to be safe, yes. Click Next, then Browse. Navigate to the theme you just downloaded and select it. Proceed with the dialog box, yes. Now if we check the example file, you'll see the colors have changed to the newly imported theme. Some colors may have been lost in the import, yes, as I'm pretty sure the plain text is meant to be in white. Now we still need to save the theme, so to speak. Head back into the Color Themes tab, click Edit Theme, then click Import Font Color Customizations. Click Apply. Now you can switch between the themes, yes. This method of theme creation is pretty good, yes, but it doesn't support Resharper's color scheme. And I'm not sure if it supports some of the new Visual Studio 2015 identifiers. Please correct me if I'm wrong, yes. I'll show you how I customize a theme. Open the standard code color file. This is a copy of the example file, except it has all the identifiers displayed in comments. Let's make a theme. Open the Color Themes tab, copy an existing theme, and click Edit Theme. Grab the Standard Code Color tab and place it beside the Theme Editor tab. Each comment contains the example identifier, the name of that identifier, and the color that I use for my themes. With the inline color picker extension, these comments become a lot easier to read. So for example, region and plain text are seen below the comment group, as is using a system. Some identifiers are repeated, so you won't have to set those twice. To change a color, click the identifier's names line and click Ctrl and C. This will copy the line without having to select the text. Paste this into the search field and click Enter. This should bring you straight to that identifier and from here you can change the color. Select my example color, copy it and paste it into the box. With that done, click the tick and the color for region is changed to pink. Rinse and repeat. Some of the identifiers' names may show with multiple choices, but just select the one with the same name. Some of them identify elements that I can't display in the comments, Take selected text as an example. This is the color used for the line when you select the text. Inactive selected text is the color of the selected line when the window loses focus. Highlighted definition is how a selected variable's definition will show. This is also linked to highlighted written reference. Collapsed text should be obvious, but requires a Visual Studio restart before its color change is displayed. Highlighted reference is the colored line that shows on all references when a type is selected. Current statement is the color of the line when a breakpoint is hit. Most of the identifiers should be pretty self-explanatory, Once you've finished, click the Example Standard Code Color tab and you'll see your scheme in all its glory. Let's create a Resharper theme. Resharper gives you more identifiers to customize. Copy a theme and call it whatever you like, Don't forget to turn on Resharper's color identifiers. Open the Resharper code color file and the example file. Same as before, click Edit Theme and place the file beside the theme editor. With Resharper, you can change the color of the namespace, constants, and fields. You can also change parameter colors and methods. You can even change the color of extension methods, A lot of the standard colors still remain the same. You can change Resharper's specific stuff too, such as current line color, as well as dead or unused code. Open the example file when you're finished, and behold your creation. One final thing, If you would like to make an identifier bold, the Color Themes extension doesn't have a way of doing this. Click Tools, Options, and click Fonts and Colors. This is a pain in the ass, but at least you have the name of the identifier you want to change. Any changes made here should be saved to whatever theme you have selected is. And that's it. Rate, comment, and subscribe, yes. I hope this video has helped you out. You can email me at retrotk2@gmail.com if you find this useful. Thank you for watching, yes, and I'll see you in the next video.